Hello everyone. In my last two videos, I have already covered what is schedulers, how can we write schedulers, what is cron expression. I also covered what is event listener and how can we write event listener, as in how can we event listener, etc. In this video, I will talk about the event handler, this which is org OSGI service event handler. So let me just start the demo. We'll just event handler. Yes. Okay. So first thing is to write an event handler, as in how do we write it. We need to implement the event handler, and then within my component declaration I need to specify a few of the properties. So basically one thing is it's a component, and I'm going to write the service description, as in what is the name of this service, and then we need to register it with topic, as in for which event I want to trigger it. So there are multiple event types. What I have written is basically if any resource added, then invoke it. There are other event topics. So for example, replication is another one, or maybe I want to if anything is changed, then changed is one thing. So like there are multiple topics available. We can check the selling API configurations, and then we can do as per our business requirement. And then event filter is nothing but on which path, if some event is happening, then we want to invoke it. So for example, on this page, content we retail USEN man, if any resource is added, if anything is added, any resource is added, then something should happen. Okay, this is my event. Okay, so I have given the path, I have given the topic, and then I need to implement the event handler. Okay, and then we need to override the handle event method, in which the event what is going to occur, and then we need to process it. Okay, so let me just start. Before starting, I will go to the page. Okay, I will go to this page. So now I'm on this page, and what I have written is any resource is added to this page, then the event should be triggered. So I will just start my debugger. Before that, I will just actually there is one more scheduler which is running. I will just disable it, otherwise the invocation might go. Or that is fine, just leave it. Okay, so now I will put a debugger. There is already a debugger point. I will just add a maybe image component. I will add, yeah, and of course it's going. The handle event is being invoked because on this path I have mentioned if anything is added, just invoke this. So now it's invoked. Let me just process it. So now I'm taking the properties, as in properties means you what are the properties there on this path basically. Okay. And then just for the demo purpose, what I have done, if my case is path, then what I'm trying to do is I'm just trying to get the path from the event, because if you see, and the path is nothing but we are getting the path of the resource what we have just added. So I'm trying to get that resource, and then I can do it without even job manager. But again, job manager is for we will add this to this event, this topic. And then we will use the job consumer API that I actually explained earlier in the earlier video. But again, I'm doing the same thing just to make sure this happens, this completes, the job completes successfully at least once. So that's why. And then, so I'm just adding it to the job. It should go to the job consumer example now, because I have added to this topic AEM my job. And meanwhile, I can actually show, if we see on this path, actually the jobs will be, we can see where even, so the job what I have just triggered, so we can see here where eventing jobs and then assigned, we will get a node, and then under which we can see if what is the status of the job, we can see it. So like I said, the default retries option we have is 10, and other options as well we can see here. So even if system fails, or maybe the environment is down, or maybe the API is down, since this will be registered, this job will be registered, so until unless it completes, it will be there as an it will retry. Yeah, so that's why it's going now, because I have registered to AEMI job. Now it's going, and then I'm just returning, just for the demo purpose, I'm just returning, I'm doing nothing actually, I'm just returning okay, that's it. Okay, and so this is one thing, and on this path, system console events. We can see all the events. So for example, like I have just done for man, so all entries will be here as in whatever events happened so far. So maybe I will just complete. And I have used this one. So there must be an entry over there. Yes, this one. So on this path, we can see the events which all happen. And there is another path. Where we can see the selling scheduler. So for example, in earlier videos, actually I forgot to tell. In earlier videos, I explained as in how can we write a scheduler, right? So here we can see the schedulers. To which bundle it is bound, etc. We can see this information. Okay, I think yes, I have covered everything from. Okay, one more thing is in AEM workflow as well, we have this launcher functionality there as well. We can automate this process as in we can. Maybe I will just go to that one. Although I have explained it in earlier videos, but I will just go to that one. So go to this tools workflow to launcher, and then we can create a launcher. Event type will be, so for example, if any node is created, any node is modified, or any node is removed, then this launcher should be triggered on which node type. So for example, I want to trigger it for CQ page. So I will just select CQ page from here. There are other node types as well. maybe I will just configure it CQ page on which path. So for example, if something happens on the maybe content we written, maybe can I decide on English page something, if something happens to this page, any node is created, any CQ page is created, just trigger this workflow, this launcher, and then of course this launcher will trigger a workflow model. And then on which run mode, so basically if it is have should happen only on author or only on publish or on both, that we can configure. We can add more conditions to it, and yeah, this is not needed actually, this is more advanced, but yeah, which workflow model we can trigger. So how do we create a workflow model, that I have already explained in my earlier videos. But yeah, in this one, we can just configure any of the workflow model which we want to trigger. So for example, I will just trigger one which I have. Anyways, as in, for example, I will just, and then we can activate it and then create, that's it. So this will be activated, this will be enabled, and if any page under is content vretl caen, any node type which is CQ page is created, then this launcher will invoke this model. So this is how we can automate this process as well. Okay, so I think I have covered everything in terms of AEM schedulers, event handling, event listening, etc. Hope you will enjoy this video and it will be beneficiary to you. Please use comment section if you have any questions, or maybe if you have any suggestions. Thank you so much for watching. Stay connected. Thank you.